Gene Caragher, marketing consultant to CPA firms, Hall of Fame. What's going on?
This is a crazy time right now, isn't it, Rick? Never in my wildest dreams did I think I would be living through a piece of history like this. We will definitely need to establish our new normal. I relate this back to 9/11, and I remember the first flight I took after 9/11 and how carefully everyone was watching each other and just how sensitive things were. You were happy to have some tall, big guys on your flight, you know, just in case. And we got back to a new normal of how, you know, we have to, you know, just watch out and take flights and pack appropriately and, you know, watch all those guidelines. So it's going to be interesting to see how we get out of this. You know, I think it's a time to reset. A lot of people are remaining in place like they should. They should be staying at home and just listening to all the warnings. But we're going to be communicating with each other in different ways, and the accounting profession will operate a bit differently.
From what you're hearing from your clients in the accounting profession, what are they expecting? What's their outlook? What are they preparing for?
Well, I'm sure, you know, right now, of course, the focus is on taking care of their people first, you know, just making sure that they're all okay and following guidelines and reaching out and communicating a lot more, not only in formal ways, but just miscellaneous calls from partners or directors to their folks just to reach out and to see how they're doing and how their families are doing. And then, of course, taking care of their clients. You know, let's face it, many of whom are suffering. There are going to be businesses that will not come back, you know, particularly from the small business side. I know these stimulus packages and all are meant to keep these businesses running and keeping people employed, but there are going to be some that unfortunately will not recover to that other side. So my CPA firm clients, you know, are focused very closely now on what can they be doing for their clients now, not just from a compliance standpoint, certainly, and, you know, getting those tax returns done, but helping them with the stimulus package, helping them with the Small Business Association loans, you know, the PPP loans, which they can apply for now, but, you know, all the regulations aren't there. You know, we read every day about some new twist or how the regulation should be interpreted, because it's important on the other side of things, too, that firms maintain as many clients as they can, you know, for their own future, you know, longevity and success, and for the employment of their people. But yet, you know, we are hearing about layoffs in the profession, kind of shocking to me, actually, with all that's going on. But we're, you know, everyone is doing their best for their clients and their people and themselves to keep their firms and client businesses operating.
What are your top recommendations for CPA firms?
Well, they need to keep their eye on the ball, right? As I talk with clients and contacts, you know, I'm someone who I work from home on a regular basis. You know, this is where my home base is when I'm not traveling to clients or conferences. I'm in a home office. So I'm accustomed, you know, to being here, you know, a lot of days, you know, on my own working. And even with that said, I need to maintain my focus because it's just, it's a different world out there. And we just, we're not used to not being able to do what we want to do when we want to do it, right? So we're all operating under a different structure. So we need to keep our eye on the ball. We need to keep our team members focused. We need to be compassionate. You know, we need to show more empathy than normal because there is a level of fear and insecurity going on. So, keep the focus. Then firms really need to listen even more to their clients and what they are struggling with. And I know CPAs do this generally, but it's even more important now because those business owners and, you know, individuals as well are frightened. You know, this is a very uncertain time. So CPAs can be those leaders to help spread a calming influence on the situation and what and how they can help their clients moving forward. So focus and being the leadership and the calming influence. And at the same time, I think this is a moment that CPAs will determine the types of clients that they want to work with going forward. And I am not saying to use this difficult time to fire clients. I'm saying just the opposite. I'm saying take care of them, listen to their concerns, help them however you can. And when we're on the other side of this, it's a time for the CPA firms and their partners to reset and examine, you know, what they did well and what they could have improved upon during this whole scenario. Again, what types of clients should they really be working with? So it's not a cliche that all of us only have so much time. And I don't mean to be dramatic about things, but, you know, living through a situation like this, I think all of us are taking a step back and thinking, how do I really want to spend my time? What types of clients do I want to work with? What sort of services do I want to provide my clients? And it's a real opportunity for CPAs to step up and not only be those leaders, but to be those advisors, being proactive. Rick, you know, in the research we've done together, clients are looking for their CPAs to be more proactive in the services and advice that they're offering. So those are just a few things, you know, off the top of my head.
They say crisis creates opportunity. What do you see as the key opportunities for accounting firms right now?
I think probably the most obvious ones are services related to the stimulus packages and how CPAs could help their clients maneuver through those regulations and processes. There are many opportunities for CPAs to continue to educate their clients on how their businesses operate and those key indicators. You know, it could be as basic as cash flow, right? And what do you need to operate your business profitably on a continual basis? There's going to be opportunities also, I think, with more of the consulting type services, more advisory type services, facilitating meetings. Unfortunately, probably bankruptcy consulting, you know, just based upon, you know, what we are bound to see going forward. So it's, as we've said for many, many years, even out of this current time, that the way accountants do business is going to change. And we all need to continue to adapt to being advisors, utilizing the technology, and now reaching out and showing that empathy and truly uncovering the needs that their clients have and the concerns that they have for their future financial stability and the long-time success of a business.
How long will this last?
I wish I knew the answer to that question. You know, we hear... I'm listening to information all day, which may or may not be the right thing to do for my sanity, but, you know, I'm listening to a lot of information. You know, as far as this COVID-19, there was a great article, I can't think of the source, and you could hover over your state and it would predict when the peak would be in your state. And for here in Florida, the peak date was May 3rd. So we're looking at almost another month before our peak, you know, gets here. So this is at least another 30 days, you know, of staying in place. And then we hear, okay, we could get over this initial bout and we'll have our numbers. And unfortunately, you know, we're going to have the fatalities and the number of people who have been impacted. And it may turn out that COVID-19 is a seasonal virus that we're going to see again. So from a COVID-19 standpoint, I'm not going to be comfortable with this until they come up with a vaccine. You know, hopefully, you know, hopefully sometime soon, you know, we can look back on this time and say, you know, remember when we lived through that? I mean, it's like our parents and all stuff with polio, you know, and other diseases and all stuff that were cured. So COVID-19, you know, is going to be a major one for us. So from a COVID-19 standpoint, it's going to be gosh, I hate to say it, but probably a couple of years. Now, economically, that's another question. The government is, providing those stimulus packages. Of course, that adds, trillions more to our debt, which is disconcerting. That's a big hole for us to be in, but it's something that's absolutely needed. Otherwise, I wouldn't call it a recession. I'd call it a depression, without this help. So the government is doing the right thing and providing these resources for individuals and for businesses so that, when it is safe to go outside, we start buying local. We start, going to our favorite restaurants again and using our local shops and everything to help them get back up on their feet. But economically, I hate to say it, and I want to leave that to the experts. But we'll see in the next 60 days where we are with the stimulus package and how well that's worked. And as the virus moves geographically, we'll see where all that plays out.
When the dust settles, how will the profession look different?
The most obvious is more firms are going to be working remotely more often. I think that's more prevalent for the smaller firms because we both know, firms already that work totally virtually anyway. So they're not changing the way they work at all. So they're ahead of the game right there. And I believe the smaller the firm, the easier it will be to do that. The larger the firm, of course, the more difficult. But even firms that have refused to initiate any sort of remote work policy have to do that now. I mean, that's going to be a given because I think a lot of employees and accountants are experiencing the joy that could be from working from home. So I think we're going to see a lot more remote work. We're going to see a lot more online meetings and training. It'll be interesting to see when the associations and different networks start meeting live again. I know a lot of conferences that have been canceled or they're being transformed into virtual events. So we're going to see a lot more of that. So we're going to have to practice our skills of communicating through our telephones or our computers because it's not going to be the same as just talking, face-to-face, live with each other. So we're going to see a lot more of that. We're going to hopefully see more empathy and compassion, like I mentioned earlier, that we could all practice more kindness with each other and the way we relate to each other in the world. And that is a positive thing. And I'll repeat what I said earlier, all of us are going to be examining, how we are spending our time and what goals we have in our lives and to adjust our work lives to accommodate what we want to accomplish in our personal lives.
Every economic cycle, every disruption of some sort brings about a shakeout or consolidation, mergers, acquisitions, winners mm-hmm. and losers. Can you tell today the difference between which firms will be winners and which ones won't be?
The winners are going to be the firms that at the right time, after we get over this initial crisis, sit down together and either review their strategic plans and marketing plan or create them so they have a definitive roadmap of where they see their firm going and the goals that they have for their firm and their people. And acknowledge how they need to do business differently in order to retain and attract team members as well as clients. And the losers are going to be the ones that feel most comfortable going back to how they have done business all along. And that is a very short-sighted way to look at things, right? Because clearly, if there's anything that any of us are learning at the moment, is that the world is going to be different, after this. And it's sad to say that, but it's going to be in positive ways as well. I don't want to be Debbie Downer, but it's going to be different. And for some CPA firm partners, that might be, you know, I've been putting off retiring for whatever reason. You know, there's lots of CPAs out there, you know, retirement age, but still just love what they do. And they're, you know, they've been putting off retirement. And I think we'll see a percentage that decides, you know what, it is time for me to retire and do some other things. And we'll see that being a reason for mergers going forward.
So you see a reason for mergers going forward?
Well, yes, I absolutely see a reason for mergers going forward. Because, you know, firms have been in discussions that now probably, you know, have been put to the side, given the priorities that we need to take at this point. But yeah, I think, you know, after we get over this initial hump, those talks are going to be reignited. And I think we're going to see more discussions going on because of the desire of partners to retire, or perhaps they feel, you know, having gone through this process, maybe we didn't do so well. You know, maybe we could have communicated better with our clients or our team members, or we really weren't prepared to work remotely like this, and we're not up to speed on the technology like we should be. And maybe this is the opportunity for us to merge into a larger firm that has those resources.
As we go through this period of consolidation, shakeout, mergers, acquisitions, who will be the winners and losers, the larger firms or the smaller firms?
I think the winners are going to be the smaller firms. I've got a couple of reasons to say that. I mentioned earlier, you know, we're already seeing some layoffs from the larger firms, and there's no reason to think that that's not going to continue. The smaller firms can be more nimble. They have the ability to really focus in when they choose to. They can, you know, the smaller firms are not these big ships that take a long time to make decisions strategically and with their business development plans. So there's not only going to be a shakeout of people from the larger firms, this is going to be an opportunity for the smaller firm to make contact with clients of larger firms that will be looking for an opportunity to see a change in their pricing, you know, and their fees, and to move to a smaller environment. You know, so we've seen that happen before too, right? That we went through this whole back in, you know, 2008, you know, all these clients looking for smaller fees and all these firms doing it, you know, for half or whatever, you know, they used to charge. You know, I hate to see that to come back again because it's so disruptive. But to answer your question, I think that the opportunities are really for the smaller firm.
So the opportunities belong to the swift and the nimble.
Absolutely, right. And focus, you know, to know, I'm getting back to, you know, so that they are the firms that are working with a partner group that have their plan. You know, they know where their firm is now. They know where they want to bring their firm. And now they need to readdress that to figure out how they're going to do it because the times have changed.
Swift, nimble, and focus. Be the watchwords.
Yep. Absolutely.
Jean Caragher, thank you. Is there anything else I should ask that I haven't asked?
I think you've done a great job, and as usual, you know, you're getting great information out there for the rest of us to listen to and to read. And it's going to be interesting to see, you know, where this road takes us going forward.